Hello, my friend, and how are you doing? And next, I'd like to give you information that how to cut electric cables and those plastic cables and tubes with Dremel multi-tool. And now I have issue that I have electric cables, where is this copper in inside, and how I can cut these cables with Dremel multi-tool. And Dremel multi-tool is really this excellent tool from USA, and I have used that Dremel multi-tool like in that my one in years, and this is really this Dremel multi-tool, this is really excellent tool. I can guarantee that this is great purchase. And I have made like tens and tens things with this tool, and now I am planning to show you that how to cut electric cables, that kind of cables, with this Dremel multi-tool. And this will be really great adventure, and let's go to look that how I use this Dremel multi-tool. And you might think that where you can purchase these things, like this Dremel multi-tool and then these accessories, these are easy to purchase in internet shopping places like Amazon.com or eBay.com. And I can guarantee that these are made and engineered in USA. And this is good tool. And then let's go to look how I use that device and tool next. Okay, and here is really this my great Dremel multi-tool, and I take these cables away, and there's Dremel is in here, and then I need some Dremel accessories like this Dremel 100 pieces kit. Now I open this part, and there is very useful cutting this glue. And they are Dremel E-Jet Speed Disc. And this is my favorite Dremel tool today. And they are like small cutting disc, look. Same like angle grinder. And this is like speed click is this tool name. And this works so that this is this drill bit, that one. And then I install this cutting disc in here. And there is idea that I have to press this little bit down, this area, and then this mount opens. And then I can install this disc in here, in that way. And then I rotate a little bit. And now this tool is ready for use. And let's look that also closer, because this is interesting. Okay, and now we can use that again, that how this tool opens, and now I disassemble that. An idea is to move that copper hole and this part in down, and same way this disc becomes loosened. Look. And now I install it down, and same, and then I have to, and I need to rotate that a little bit, and then disc is free, and back installation happens again, but I move that little bit down, and then this part opens, look, opens, close, and this is like open position. Now I press, and then I take disc, and it goes directly in here, and then I have to rotate that little bit, look, in that way, that it locks, listen, now it locks. And now this part is ready for use, and I take this my Dremel, and Dremel installation happens that there is blue button, what I have to press, and same time I have to rotate this part in this way, and then I install this cutting disc in here, and then I have to rotate that nut in another direction, and look, I press this blue button all time. And now when this nut is not working, not moving, then this disc is ready for use. Excellent. And then we go to
test this migraine. Next.
Okay, and now I start this my cutting demonstration with this aluminium, cable or tube or hose, and I use now this Dremel cutting disc for this 38 millimeter and E-Jet speed disc, excellent quality, and this is like multi-purpose cutting disc, and there is this drill bite, and I firstly load that a little bit down, and then I install this my disc in here. It is good to compress with table, and then to install this disc, and then small rotation, and we can see this small click, listen. And this is quality. Similar like in Toyota parts and Toyota things, we can hear the same kind of click. And then I install this my drill bite in this my Dremel, and I press locking button, and then this locking bolt, I rotate that with my fingers. Okay, and now it's ready. And there is this switch, and soon I will insert this with something like speed 6 to 8, maybe sometimes in even this 10. Okay, and here is this, I have more of this speed disc, and we can purchase this disc in any of hardware store like Home Depot, and there is by the way steel logo, that this is even suitable for steel, and then we can also use this Dremel's cut-off feel number 409, and there is this standard cutting disc, and this works also, but this is not so durable than this speed disc, but this is also fine, and there is really 36 pieces, and these parts cost about that unit is $5, and then this speed disc set is about $10, and these discs are really durable. It is amazing to see that what is this Dremel's quality. Okay, and then I start this my job, and there is my cutting disc, and first material is aluminium, and this is really this solid aluminium, like 5 millimeters thickness, and let's look what it works and how this cutting works. And now I have to use also protective things, and let's look those also. Okay, and first we have to use these protective glasses always, and the brand should be high quality. In USA I only recommend 3M's glasses and products. And there is then this my, also this makes quite bad sound, and there is my 3M's hearing protector. I recommend also these, and 3M is excellent. And then I start my machine, and let's do cutting in here. And now when we have very thin of these cables, I can use my fingers, and I need only gloves that I protect, and I keep my hand in here, and when we have very thin cables we can use only hand, but then when we have bigger cables we need workbench, and this workbench is, it looks like that, and it is device where we can move this handle in that way, and then this part moves in here, and it compress these two yaws and these parts together, and I can insert this my cable in here in nicely. And let's look at how it really happens when I rotate that in that way, and soon we can see that how this my system works. Okay, now I have adjusted that more, look, there is thin amount, and now I install this my cable in here, very nicely in same plane as this my workbench, this level in that way,
Now I am planning to cut like 1 inch part. And this workbench is really the best one. Okay, and now this my device is in position, look. And in that case, when I move that in this direction, this compress in this way. This is this togue, more togue. And then this togue is right when I take my fingers, and then this my cable is not moving anymore. And now I can rotate my this workbench in here, and next I cut this amount in here with my Dremel. And let's look at how it happens. Okay, and here is my Dremel, and first switch to 3. Okay. And cutting is here. Little bit more power. More speed. Okay. And now this my aluminium cutting is ready. Look. And there is this my nice part. And when I use this Dremel, I can make these cuttings in very nice look. And if I use tongs, then this area is more rough and hard. And that's this Dremel is really useful. And there we can see that this my cutting is ready. And now I can release this my workbench. And then I can cut next material. Okay, and then my next material is that how I can cut these electric cables. And now I have really this standard car copper cable, and there are those connectors, and now I need to cut like in that area in here. And now I can do so that I can keep this in my hand or then insert in here. And let's look at how this Dremel works. First I start that, and speed is now 8. And look how nicely this Dremel works. And now I have nice cutting, and there is this another part, and there is this great area in here. And this is like copper electric cable cutting. And let's go to cut next material. Okay, and then I have in here real copper, this very small cable. And for that cutting, if I need to cut these, it is easy to install in a little bit in that way. And then I use this my workbench. I insert this my cable in here, because it is easier to work with that way. And now it's solid. And then I cut this in here. And let's look at how it happens. And speed again 3. Thank you. And now these cables, they cut in very nicely. And there was really many of these copper cables, look. And very, very nice work. And then we go to next material. Okay, and then my next material is steel cable. Look, this is real steel. And this is difficult to cut with tongs, like in that way, because this is so hard, this steel wire. And now I have to use this workbench, because this steel is so hard material to keep in hand. And now I again open my workbench. This is opening direction. And I install my cable in here. And then again. And then, my friend, you might think that where you could purchase this workbench. Okay, there is good place. This HomeDepot.com in USA, like California, Miami and all states. And this cost about $20 to $30. And this is real iron and steel. And this is really useful tool. And this is heavy. This weighs about 10 pounds or 5 kilos. And now when I have installed this my workbench, there is idea that this area must be in tight in here. And I cut that in here, and let's look also closer. Okay, and now we can see that area closer, and then I take my Dremel, and I cut these things in here. And speed is again 8. And look how nice cutting and how fast it is. Look. This is very good work. Look. Very nice cutting and how fastly. And this is like 3 millimeter steel cable. That one. Okay, and then we go next material. And my next material is really interesting. This is like car big half inches, this copper cable, and there is big fuse, and we use that this thickness thick cables when we have really big subwoofer or speakers and those items what consumes huge amount of electricity. And now I am planning to. This is like power cable. Look, there is 8 millimeter is this distance power cable. And now I cut this my cable in here because I like to do better cutting than that one. Look, this is a little bit dirty. And now I need again to use my workbench. And I open that a little bit and soon we can see very nice cutting. And now I install and look. This is idea that this must be in plane, not in that way. This is wrong. In that area. And then I compress my workbench. And this is really, this workbench is really useful. And only so much that this is not moving. Okay. And then I cut this thing. And let's look at what is result. Okay. And now I start to use this my Dremel. And speed is 8. Okay, and look how nice cutting, look, in here, this is like art. Okay, and look how nice cutting with this Dremel multi-tool. It is really excellent cutting in here. Excellent. Okay, and then I like to cut to you. This is real, this home construction steel nail. And of course I like to show that how to cut that one. And now I install that firstly. And now I need again this my workbench in here, good. And I cut this in this area. And now we can see that closer this part. And I start my Dremel. Okay, excellent. Now we can see that how nice this cutting is. Look, it is really nice. Okay, and now my nail is ready. And in that way, I have showed to you that how to use this great Dremel tool for many different things. Cutting, and remember that you can also cut any material with that Dremel multi-disc. And look, and it is Dremel speed disc is this disc name. And now we can also check that how much this Dremel has been worn out, and it is really minimum amount. And that's, these are really durable, and you can purchase this E-Jet speed disc in Home Depot or Amazon.com webpage. Okay, and my friend, then we continue.
Okay, and now we have seen that how great tool is this Dremel multi-tool, and I can really recommend that Dremel tools to you, because I have used those Dremel tools now about 10 years and no any issues. Excellent product from USA. And if you think that where you can get these Dremel tools, I can give three places to shop. First one is those Home Depot centers. Please visit those excellent places. And then of course Amazon.com and eBay.com. And thank you my friend for watching that Dremel video, and see you in next video, and happy day to you, and be happy and be positive.